item at the next meeting in November, which will highlight a bit more specifically some of the projects moving forward. So just note that and explain just for the update. So can we agree that then we just complete that and move on? Okay, so item 5 is the area-based review. So can I just say that if we take that with item 5 and 6, and Ian, you can maybe just quickly on the commission side of it. So Sue, do you want to talk to us about the area-based review draft, if you... We know it doesn't complete till the end of this month, but you just give us an update.
Members up to speed with where we are with the review. The fan steering group takes place next week, and just a reminder of what the review was about. It was very much nationally driven in terms of having institutional structures that offer high quality provision based on the current and future needs of our area. Because we're a depot area, the combined authority has introduced a number of additional lines of inquiry to the review, where we've looked at apprenticeships, specialisation, the curriculum, A levels of transport, to name a few. We had 7 FE colleges in scope, 3 sixth forms and 1 school sixth form, just to remind you there which ones they were. Why the review matters? Well, the national focus is very much on financial sustainability of colleges. What we've tried to do here in the City Region is really use the review as an opportunity to shape future curriculum so that we can meet the growth priorities in terms of high-level skills and also how we can work with partners to encourage greater areas of specialisation. There has been work going on to reconfigure or to look at options to reconfigure college delivery structures, and the do is reach a conclusion, we can move on and establish the commission and start to do sort of preparatory work around the evidence base and working with the LEP to make sure we get the right businesses sat around the table. Thanks, Chair.
Okay, thanks for that, Sue. Ian, do you want to make comments on that in particular relation to this commission?
Chair, as you know, Skills Commission, where we want to go, where we are going. It was certainly my view that if we got in any depth and set the Skills Commission while the early evasion review was going on, it could be conflicting. So it's been a good and wise decision, I think, just to wait until we come to the conclusion of the early evasion review before we move on to the Skills Commission. As Sue's just said, we are coming to the end of that process. Our final meeting is next week. And of course, we've been talking in the background about the Skills Commission. Once those findings are out on the table, we'll be moving much more quickly in setting up the Skills Commission. And I'll leave it there, Chair.
No, that's fine, because I think at the end of the day, we all know the structural forms that we support in the Turkish community parties. This is now about the delivery on those issues of greater specialisation, all the issues that are important to us. We will be, of course, responsible for delivering on the findings. So the report will come to us at the same time as it goes to government, and I think you're right, we need it to wait before we get the report for the commission to be set up. I think the commission can now be established, knowing full well that the report will feed into that as well, so that's important. Okay, so with those comments from Ian, can we thank Sue for the report, and we will get the final report when it concludes. 28 this month. Okay. Thanks for that. Okay, if we then move on to again, it's an item under the local growth fund, there's the approval of the business case for Maghull North Railway Station. And again, it's pretty explicit in terms of the issues that the reason why it's been held back. Frank, do you? Any comments you want to quickly make on this?
Yeah, just very quickly, please. This is the 12th out of 14 transport solution of the F1 going forward for approval now. Key challenge here is that the network rail group through estimate for this scheme has now put the cost at 13 million. That's an increase of funding requirement from the LGF process of 4.5 million. So we're asking for the CA to approve that additional funding. The TAG have already recommended the project. The LEP board have already recommended the project, so we're now asking for the CA approval to proceed.
Yeah, no, as I said, it's pretty clear and straightforward and the reasons why we're within that. I'm sure we will let what the increase in cost. Okay, so can we read the recommendation set out within that before, please? Not paying anyone. Thank you. Okay, item 8 is the appointment of Liverpool City Leader and Commander of Policy Scrutiny Panel. I think it just notes that the Open Council have advised of a change in one of their nominations to the scrutiny panel and sets that out within the report. And so that's all the report does is set out those changes, and it's just for us to approve them. So can I ask that recommendation to approve that change set up? Okay, item 9 is the